Yes, candles still burning at this memorial, and a few people still stopping by at this hour to show their respects and pay their respects for Kathleen Payton and her daughter, Jasmine.
I don't want to die before her.
Thomas Purdy stands at this memorial set up to honor his life partner, 31-year-old Kathleen Payton.
My lady, my girlfriend.
And her 10-year-old daughter, Jasmine, who he loved as his own.
It went from Daddy Thomas to Daddy, and ever since then, it was Daddy.
Purdy tells Fox 31 he will always regret not being home when fire destroyed this section of the Tiffany Square apartment complex.
I was supposed to be here to either try to help them, help us get out, or die with them. And that was that's our pack rules.
She wasn't just my niece, but she was one of my best friends.
Peyton's aunt Janelle Camacho tells Fox 31 the world has lost two beautiful souls.
She just loved to play. She loved her LOL dolls.
Both say the thought of two juveniles setting the fire that also displaced 32 families from 14 units is unbearable.
They didn't think about themselves. They didn't think about their future. They didn't think about their family.
I feel that the parents should be held accountable as well as the children, because at that hour of the morning, at 4 o'clock in the morning, and these kids are out here starting a fire.
Purdy still wears this whistle around his neck, used to keep Jasmine safe from a distance.
I blow once, that means it's too far. I blow twice, she means come back.
While the whistle no longer works, he will keep it close to his heart forever, along with the memory of his family.
The other memory I have is my house key.
And as we come back live, you are looking at a picture of the vigil, the candle still burning, and Purdy now sitting all by himself, playing music, looking at pictures as well, praying for his family, Kathleen and Jasmine. Now, of course, we have mentioned that this is now a homicide investigation. Police are looking for two boys in this case, not releasing the names because they are juveniles. But they say warrants are out for their arrest, and they both could face murder and arson charges in the first degree. Reporting live in Lakewood, Shaul Turner, Fox 31.